Because any infliction or anything that befalls by way of a calamity or tribulation upon a Muslim, the first thing that the Muslim does is return it back to himself. That he returns back to himself. And the Muslim is introspective. That he looks towards, what have I done to deserve this? Maybe there was something by way of the sunnah that I left. Maybe there's something by way of obedience to Allah that I've left. Without a shadow of a doubt, you do certain things, certain results will occur. A maxim or a principle in Islam, al-jaza min jinsil amal, that the recompense is according to your deeds. If your deeds are good, your recompense is good. If your deeds are bad, then the recompense is bad. The recompense is going to be likewise. Al-jaza min jinsil amal, a universal principle. Do good and you will receive good. Do evil and you'll be recompensed and punished for the evil that you do. Let's not look for exit strategies from why the Muslims are in the state that they're in. The reason why we're in the state that we're in, that we are the result of that which the Muslims are being inflicted with today. And all of these other things that you see, the attack upon the Muslims, the weakening of the Muslims being divided and hating each other, the enemy overpowering and entering the Muslim lands and no one cares. And there is no and even to resist is something that is impossible. Why? Is it because of the strength of the enemy? Or is it because of the weakness of the Muslim in Iman? Ya ikhwan, it is the latter, not the former. It is the weakness of the Iman, of the believer, that has caused Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that results in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending down upon him his humiliation. And then Allah mentions, or the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, that Allah will not remove his humiliation up until you return back to what? To jihad? To terrorism? To killing yourself? Suicide bombings? Indiscriminate killing? Planting bombs in substation, in underground stations? Blowing up trains and airplanes? What did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? Humiliation is removed how? Do we accept the concept that many of the people who propagate the ideology of terrorism in our times, that they say that the humiliation will be removed by way of suicide bombings? Humiliation will be removed by way of airplane hijackings. Humiliation of the Muslims will be removed by way of insurgency and terrorism and taking, as they claim, the terror to the Western lands, to the capitals of the Western nations. Ya ikhwan, this is not what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, la yanzi'uhu, that Allah will not remove the humiliation up until you return back to your deen. He didn't say return back to killing. He didn't even say return back to jihad. He didn't say return back to jihad. He said, hatta tarji'u ila deenikum, up until you return back to your religion, he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So let me ask you, ya ikhwan, what is the deen of al-Islam? What is the deen that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with? It is the deen that primarily and first and foremost establishes the correct Islamic aqidah, the correct Islamic belief and creed. This is what we have to return back to. If we wish for all of this humiliation to be relieved, or the Muslims to be relieved from that, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad, وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.